Hello everybody, welcome back. Another quick CapCut tutorial. In this one, gonna show you how to blur out anything. Blur out faces, blur out objects, blur out license plates, you name it, I'm gonna show you how to do it, and I'm gonna show you how to do it in motion. Look at this here. You'll see the camera is moving all over the place, but the blur always stays on the criminal's face. How did I do that? I'm gonna show you how to do this. It should take about 90 seconds or so. Let's go. All right, so I've deleted everything off of the timeline. Keep in mind, this is CapCut for the desktop PC or Mac. So here we go. The first step, just bring some footage in and then drag and drop it onto the timeline. Immediately after that, you can do the two things. You can drag the footage on top of it again, so you've got both pieces of footage where you need them to be. Alternatively, I'll delete that. I can actually go ahead and hold down the Option key on a Mac, Alt key on a PC, and push up, and that creates a duplicate copy. So that's step one. All right, so the next step is on the bottom video, making sure you've selected the bottom video, click on this little eyeball that says hide track. We're gonna hide this for now, and then we're gonna turn it on at the end so you can see how the effect turned out. So there we go, we've turned that off. Now I'm going to click back onto the top track, and then on the right side under video, we have a few options. What we wanna do is we wanna select the masking option. Now under mask, you're gonna see a few different styles of mask. Depending on what you're going for, in this case, I'm going for a circle blur, but if you wanted to do a rectangular blur, go nuts, here it is. And I'll also even show you how to do a background blur, but here is the circle blur, and this is a circle mask. So I'm just gonna go ahead and click on circle, and you'll see here we get this circle with some crosshairs looking in it. And now I'm just gonna click on it, and I'm gonna move it over the area that I want to blur. Now this is a little bit too big compared to what I want, so I'm just gonna go ahead and pull it in. Keep in mind that it is generally better to have more things blurred if you have a little bit outside the lines than to under blur, because that can lead to, you know, big trouble. So it just, yeah, a little bit extra never hurts. Okay, there we go. Now under here, we're gonna see the feather option. I like to feather the outside by about 4 pixels or so, just so that it isn't such a hard blur. It's kind of blends into the end. So there you go. We went and clicked on mask, we clicked on circle blur, and then we feathered it for 4 pixels. Now, let's get into the next step. All right, so the next step is, again, making sure you're selected on the top video. We are going to have to move this circle or the mask, because in this video, his head moves around. Now, if you don't have that in your video and it's just a solid object or a solid something and it doesn't move around, you don't need to follow this step, but if it moves a little bit, here's how you do it. So under the mask, you'll see, of course, we've got our mask selected, but what we wanna do is we wanna click on this diamond right here. This adds a keyframe, and what this is gonna allow us to do now is it allows us to move the mask. So we're gonna basically move the blur. So I'm gonna go forward a little bit here, and in this, I'm just moving it forward like just a second or so. I'm just gonna move it along, and then I'm gonna go forward a second or so, and I'm just basically centering it around his face. You can do this as you see fit. Here we go, something like that. And then we're gonna go like that, there we go. And then let's go right here. Okay, yeah, that's a little bit in your face, there we go. And then finally I'll go to the end and I'll move it about there. Okay, good, so there we go. We've animated the mask so that we can animate the blur. All right, now it's time to cook. So I'm just gonna move the playhead back to the beginning. That's optional, but I like to do that. The next step is I'm gonna go ahead and click on effects. And under effects, I'm gonna type into the search bar, blur, and hit enter. You have to hit enter for some reason. It doesn't bring it up automatically. Now, believe it or not, the very first blur out of all these blur effects is usually the best one. I've tried them all, and this one works really, really good. And if I hover over it, you can already see how good it's working. So I'm gonna drag and drop it, but make a note, I'm not dropping it on top of the first video. I'm dropping, pardon me, on top of the video track. I'm actually dropping it onto the video itself. And it's a very important point, because if this is purple and it's in a video track, it won't work. So I've gone ahead and dropped it onto the video just like that. And then you'll see here that we've got the blur. Now, all I gotta do is crank this up to about 100. And now watch this. It's going to move the blur perfectly. See that? The blur is following his face and it's looking great. Now, this is why we turned the track off at the beginning. If I turn the track on, now only his face is going to be blurred, guaranteed. All right, watch this. He's blurred out, it's moving, it's following him. This is how you blur in CapCut the right way. Thanks for watching.